Hello, my name is Gustavo Sosa. I'm a Qualcomm Technology Video from ST Microelectronics. This is the scroll list second video of three. In previous video, we created a user interface. In this one, we will add a code to use the scroll list. Now, we'll open CubeID project. Click at the folder icon at the bottom left. Go one directory up. Open STM32CubeID folder. Double click at .cproject or .project file. At workspace path pop-up window, click at launch. At successful imported project pop-up window, click at OK. Expand the project, then application, user, GUI, and open custom container CPP file. We'll add a code that will assign the corresponding image and text to each item at the scroll list. We need to know the name inside TouchFX and how to refer to each image and text. We add a header files for the text and images. With the mouse right button, we'll open the text header file and take a look as an example. We can see the enumeration with all the text resources. The images header file is something similar. Close the text header file and, with the mouse right button, now open custom container 1 header file. Just add the definition of the function we had created. Save both files using the Save All Files icon at the top. Now, open Screen1View CPP file. With the mouse right button, open Screen1View header file. At public, add the definition of the function that will be used to update the scroll list elements. This function name and the function was predefined by TouchFX at the Screen1ViewBase HPP file, but we need to override it and implement it at the user code. At protected, add the definition needed for the selected item callback. This callback will be called when an item is selected from the scroll list. Finally, return to Screen1View CPP file. First, we'll add a scroll list one update item function that we had defined and need to override. The name is just a name we gave to the scroll list widget at TouchFX Designer and update item. In this function, we are calling the function at the custom container 1 to place the items. Now, let's add the callback function when an item from the scroll list is selected. Here, we will assign the image and text at the left side of the screen to know which item of the list is selected. We are doing it in the same way as in the container. Next, we need to add a header files with the definitions of the images and the text. Now, we'll assign the callback function to the function we had created. This step is done in two lines. Finally, save all files and compile with the icons at the top. After compilation is complete, change to TouchFX Designer and run the simulator with the button at the bottom. Here is what we had created. Each time an item in the scroll list is selected, it is displayed at the left side as acknowledged. Now, let's improve it a bit by changing the scroll list to be circular and we'll add a second screen. This will be done at the third part. Thank you for watching.